Bardas Skleros or Scleros was a Byzantine general who led a wide-scale Asian rebellion against Emperor Basil II in 976-979. Background. Bardas belonged to the great family of the Scleroi, which owned enormous estates at the eastern outskirts of Asia Minor. His mother Gregoria descended from Basil I's brother Bardas. The greatest coup of his early career was a brilliant defense of Constantinople against the army of Sviatoslav I of Kiev in 970. During the Battle of Arkadiopolis, he reportedly managed to inflict as many as 20,000 casualties on the Rus, while the campaign claimed the lives of merely 25 Greek soldiers. After he had shown himself equal to dealing with the fiercest enemies of Byzantium, Bardas became a trusted advisor to John I Zimisces, who was likewise of Armenian stock and his brother-in-law. Upon John's death, Scleros aspired to replace him as an acting emperor. The eunuch Basil Lekarpenos, who actually led the imperial government, entertained other plans. However, deposing Bardas from his key post of general in the east in 975, according to Michael Salozed, Scleros was a man who was not only a competent planner, but extremely clever in carrying out his schemes. Possessed of vast wealth, with the prestige of royal blood and of success in great wars, with all the military cast at his side to help on his enterprise, rebellion. Upon hearing the news of his deposition, Scleros came to an agreement with local Armenian, Georgian and even Muslim rulers who all vowed to support his claims to the imperial crown. He successfully stirred up rebellion among his relatives and adherents in the Asian provinces, rapidly making himself master of Caesarea, Antioch, and most of Asia Minor. After several navy commanders defected to Scleros's side, he dashed to Constantinople, threatening to blockade the Dardanelles. The rebel navy under Michael Kourtikios raided the Aegean and attempted to blockade the Dardanelles, but were defeated by the imperial fleet. Having lost supremacy at sea, Scleros at once laid siege to the town of Nicaea, which was considered a key to the capital. The town was fortified by a certain Manuel Eroticos, father of the future emperor Isaac Komnenos and progenitor of the Komnenoi dynasty. Meanwhile, Basil recalled from exile Bardas Phokas the Younger, a general who had revolted in the previous reign and been interned in a monastery for 7 years. Phokas proceeded to Sebaste in the east, where his family domains were situated. He came to an understanding with David III Kuropalats of Tau, Tyche, who pledged 12,000 Georgian horsemen under the command of Tornikios to Phokas' aid. Scleros instantly left Nicaea for the east and defeated Phokas in 2 battles, but the latter was victorious in a third. On March 24, 979, 2 leaders clashed in single combat, with Scleros cutting the right ear of Phokas' horse with his lance before sustaining a grave wound to the head. The rumor of his death put his army to flight, but Scleros himself found shelter with his Muslim allies. Thereupon the rebellion was subdued without difficulty. Later years, after the Asian potentates refused to support his further operations against Constantinople, Scleros and his family retreated to Baghdad in 980. They resided in honorable captivity at the Caliph's court for 6 years, dreaming about the invasion of Byzantium. In 987, Scleros was finally recalled to his homeland by Phokas, who took advantage of the Bulgarian wars to aim at the crown. Scleros promptly mustered an army to support Phokas's cause, but his plans of profiting from the attendant disorders were frustrated when Phokas had him committed to prison. Upon Phokas' death at the Battle of Abydos, Scleros succeeded him as the leader of the rebellion. The truth was, the men who had enrolled in Scleros's army were no longer divided in their loyalties. Every one of them was a declared rebel. Their leader inspired them with his own resolute determination and bound them into one coherent body. By favors he won their loyalty, by his kindliness he earned their devotion. He reconciled their differences, ate at the same table as his men, drank from the same cup, called them by name, and by his flattery bound them to his allegiance. The date of his surrender to the authorities is disputed, as are the circumstances. In 991, Scleros, a blinded and broken man, then residing in semi-captivity in Thrace, was visited by Emperor Basil II on his way to Bulgaria. The famous rebel accepted the title of Curopalates and died several days later, presumably on April 2. Descendants. The bloodline of Badis Scleros continued, however. A grandson, Basil Scleros, was married to a sister of Emperor Romanos III. One of Basil's daughters married Constantine Monomachos, who would become emperor, while Basil's granddaughter became mistress of Constantine. One of these women was the grandmother of Vladimir Monomach.